Okay, welcome back once again to MBAbullshit.com. So our topic for this video is value of a perpetuity. Alright, so remember you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com for lots of cool videos to help you out on these topics. Now, before this video, you should already know on future value and present value. So you can watch my other free videos on future value and present value if you do not know these topics yet. Alright, so let's start with an easy question, and it will also continue to be easy, I promise. Alright, what if you had $100 in the bank and the bank was giving you 5% interest per year, every year, forever? Okay, so how much cash will you get every year? Okay, you get 5%, so how much cash is that every year? That's easy. $100 times 0.05, which means 5%, you'll get $5 per year. Okay, now that's very easy. So now let's turn the story around. What if you want the bank to give you $5 per year forever? Okay, how much do you need to deposit? Well, we already know $100. Okay, same as here. Okay, same as here. So now the question is, what if you had a magic wand and it guaranteed that you will get $5 every year for the rest of your life? Okay, this is $5 every year for the rest of your life. Okay, if someone wanted to buy this magic wand from you, how much would you sell it? Okay, well, you would sell it for a certain amount of money, okay, so that you can put this money in the bank, and then you will continue to earn $5 a year forever in interest. Okay, so how much is that? Well, we already know it's $100, right? You need to sell this wand for $100 so that you can put the $100 in the bank and you can continue to earn the $5 a year that this wand was giving you. Alright? Simple. Very simple. So now, I've got good news for you, and that is that this magic wand actually exists. Okay? Now, however, it doesn't really look like a wand. It looks like a piece of paper or contract, and it is called a perpetuity. Alright? It's called a perpetuity. So it comes from the word perpetual, which also means forever. So I don't know, if you're Catholic, you know, the Catholics, they pray to this, is it Mother of Perpetual Help or something like that? I think Mother Mary, or no, in some Christian funerals, they say, oh God, Catholic funerals, they say, God, please let your perpetual light shine upon, shine upon his soul. That means, please shine upon his soul forever. Excuse me. Alright, so now, how do we mathematically estimate the value of the magic wand, or the value of the perpetuity? Okay, how did we mathematically get the value of 100? Okay, so for that we use an easy formula which looks like this. Okay, value of a perpetuity equals the yearly cash flow divided by the interest rate. Okay, and you already know that the yearly cash flow is $5 and the interest rate is 5%, written mathematically as 0.05, and we find that $5 divided by 0.05 is $100. So there you can see how simple it is to get the value of a perpetuity. Alright? So now that you know the basic concept of how to get a value of a perpetuity, you're now ready to move on to our next video on the value of a growing perpetuity, where the cash payment increases every year. So in this case, it was just a flat $5 every year, and every year it was the same. But what if this increases every year to a bigger than $5, and then bigger the next year, and even bigger the next year? So that is called the value of a growing perpetuity. And if you're interested in this, you can check out this next video on MBAbullshit.com. So if you like this basic video, remember to share it if you like it. On Twitter, we're MBAbullshit. And on Facebook, you just type our website, www.mbabullshit.com, or you can simply forward our YouTube link on your email to your friends. So, have a great day. Goodbye.